started just a couple minutes ago.
I would grab that, yeah, just in case. You might want to just bring some wipes with you so you can wipe it off before and after you use it.
Thank you.
deep breath in at the bottom. Exhale, peel back up off the floor. Shoulders down, way, way down, and the neck is long. Lift your toes. Now pulse those hips. 1, 2, 3. Good. Going for 3, 6, 7. Suck your belly button toward the spine. Good. You got it, guys. Breathe. I really want you to dig into that movement, especially as you start to get tired. We're waking up our glutes. Lift the toes up off the floor. If you're not sure if your alignment is proper, make sure your knees, hips, and ankles are all lined up. We have our last 3, 2, and 1. Now release down, knees to chest. You can grab a quick stretch for whatever you think might need it. Great. Now let's come into single leg glute bridge. Soles of the feet to the floor. We're going to leave those hips down for now. Bring the right knee to the chest and cross that shin over the left thigh. Press your DM to the side, arms out to the side for balance, and then we're going to lift up. Just push into your supporting heel. You can readjust to center that foot if it's more comfortable for you. Now single reps. Ready? Down and up. Down and up. Here's 3. We're going to go for 15 on each side. 5. Lift your toes up off the floor if you can. Right on, guys. This is 9. We're almost there. 5 more to go. 5, 4, 3. Push the floor away from you when you come up. Last one. Good. Release down. Release the leg. You can hug the knees and the chest to loosen up that lower back. And then we'll come to the other side. So right foot to the floor. Left shin crosses over. Knee presses out to the side. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. Lift the hips. Good. Just hold on top. Drive down on your supporting heel. Bring it closer to the center if you need to. And here we go. Single reps. Down and up. Down and up. Keep the neck long. The shoulders relaxed. Right on, guys. Looking good. Awesome. You're more than halfway. This is number 10. Suck that belly button in. Lift your toes up off the floor. You have 3 more. 2. And last one. Bring those feet down. Separate your feet to hip width apart. Suck the belly button towards the spine. Make sure you're not hyperextending the lower back. Now let's merge. Knee in and back. And in and back. Remember that you can take a break anytime you need one. Check in with your lower back. Make sure everything feels fairly comfortable. And we're breathing deeply. 4 more. Good. Last 2. Last 1. Roll that spine back down. Knees can come to the chest. Quick stretch for wherever you need it. Great. Now release the upper body. Leave the legs where they are. And now we're going to adjust so those shins are parallel with the floor and knees are up over the hips. Good. Spread the arms wide. Palms down. And now we're going to extend one leg out. And bring it back in. Bend the knee to the other side. Extend it out. And bring it back in. Now I want you to be moving super slow. Good. Suck your belly button toward the spine. Push your lower back into the floor. Try not to let your back pop up if you can help it. Breathe deep. Right on. You got it, guys. Exhale on the exertion. One more time each side. Really slow. Out. And back in. Last one here. Out. And back in. And release. Grab that stretch. And now we're going to come into upper abdominal muscles, fingertips to temples, or behind the head. Inhale at the bottom. Exhale, crunch up. Inhale, down. Exhale, crunch. Inhale, down. Exhale, crunch. Good. Yes. Inhale, down. Now you can speed it up if you're ready. Down and up. And up. And down. I want you to make sure you're keeping the elbows wide and the neck long. Shoulders are down and there's never any strain in the neck. We never bring the chin to the chest. We're just working on those middle and upper abdominal muscles. Inhale down, exhale up. 4 more. 4. and center. Then to the other side, keep your knees and ankles together and center. And then tip and center. Suck the belly button toward the spine and breathe really slowly. Now, if this is not intense enough for you, straighten the legs out. Tip to one side and bring it back to center. Tip to the other side, suck that belly button in. Try and keep your knees and ankles together throughout the movement. Push the arms into the floor for balance and stability, but bring most of that stability from your core. Good, last one here, nice and easy to the side, and back in and release. Quick stretch wherever you need it. Great, we're gonna do our back from standing today, so I'd like you to roll over into a table pose to start, and then just curl the toes under, lift the hips. Quick stretch, walk the hands back toward the feet. Then knees roll up, shoulders down, and you can reach up if you want to, guys. Stretch with me. And then release, and then we're going to tip forward from the hip. Hands to thighs to start, and I want you to check the shoulders never come out toward the ears. If you need to, you can bring one hand back down to the thigh anytime. We're tucking the elbows in. Suck your belly button toward the spine. Knees are slightly bent. Now here, I want you to just push into the outside of your feet just a little bit. Feel the stability through your lower body and your lower back. Your back is straight, and now we're going to reach those arms out in front and line with the ears. Good. Now let's swing them back down, walk side body, and forward. And back. And forward. If this is not hard enough for you, tip forward further. I want you to feel the muscles of the middle and lower back working, as well as your core. Suck your belly button in. Breathe. A few more just like that. Back. And forward. Back. Nice. And forward. Last one here. Push into the outside of the feet. Hands to thighs. Curve around. Good. We're going to come back for our next movement. Remember, one arm at a time is fine. Coming into our standing W. Reach those arms out in front. Palms face the floor. Inhale. Extend. Exhale. Elbows toward the tailbone. Exhale, thumbs towards your shoulders. Same movement. Elbows toward the tailbone, thumbs toward the shoulders. Reach out. And pull back. One more time. Slow. Tip forward further. If you want more, let's double time. Ready? Reach and pull. Reach. Nice. Looking good, guys. Squeeze your core. Push into the outside of the feet. Four more. Three. Two. Keep those arms nice and high. Last one. Hands to thighs, curve around, roll up, shoulders down, reach up, excellent, okay, so now coming into a nice easy standard squat, hands can be anywhere that's comfortable for you except around the thighs, I want your feet hip width apart, or wherever your regular stance is for today, so stop your feet into the floor, just like I did, and that's going to show you where your natural stance should be, knees are soft, tailbone tucked, and I just want you to squat down to your lowest point. That might be where your hips are at level with your knees, might be lower. Don't let your arm tuck. Arm positioning is up to you. Inhale at the bottom, push to the outside of the feet, and exhale, come on up. Good. Slow breaths. Inhale down. Exhale up. Good. Inhale down. Exhale up. So when we squat, we'd like to try and keep our body at the same angle as our shins. So we never want to be tipping forward too far, right? Keep those knees bending and dropping the body straight down as much as you can. Excellent, yes. Now I want you to decide what your halfway point is for your squat. We're going to come down there just to the halfway point. Now let's pulse. Seven, six, five. Shoulders down. Three, two, and stand. Oh, that's your break. Come on now. Seven, six, five. Suck your belly button in. Three, two, and stand. One more time. Down. Seven, six, five, four, two, and one. All right. Great job. Take it off. Lunge time. One leg comes back. Toes point forward. Shoulders down and back. Suck your belly button in. Now come down super slow. Four, three, two, one, and up. Three, two. You don't have to touch the floor. Just come down as far as it's comfortable for you. And back up for four, three, two, one. And down. Three, pushing your front heel. That's three, and three, two, and up. Nice. Two more just like that. Two, and up. Last one here. Three, two, and up. Excellent. Stepping in, stepping back. And we're finding our lunge position. Extra slow first. Come on down. Good. All the way to the bottom, whatever that means to you. You don't have to touch the floor. And then we'll come on back up. We're going to speed it up just a little bit. Ready? Down for four, three, two, one, and up. Ooh. Slow it right down. Yeah, I know. It's not easy. Excellent. Two more just like that. Good job. Suck the belly button toward the spine. Breathe deep. Good. Yes, I know we're feeling it. This is endurance and training here. Now, ready? Let's come down for three, two, and up fast. Do it again. Three, two, and up. Three, two, and up. So what we're doing is we're playing with what's called rep tempo, the timing of our repetitions, and this helps to change up our metabolism. Last one here. Two and one. Good. Step in, step back. That one we just did where you come into control, concentric, your three and up fast for one is known as metabolic training. Okay, so use that in the gym. Now, one more squat before we change our focus group for our muscles. Feet flat on the floor, you can stomp them in again, and then we're going to work one heel and one toe out wider. Turn the toes out. Replié. Come on down, push your knees up. Now, I want you to just notice, you might stay up here on the top, and that's fine. What we want is for our knees to feel safe and not to buckle in. So if you're doing that, you can help it, or if they hurt, turn your toes forward, bring your feet closer together anytime. Now come down lower if you can. Push into your toes. Pulse. One, two, three. Good. We're going for 20. This is seven. Suck your belly button in. Nine, 10. This is known as an isometric pulse. So when you're pulsing for 1 to 3 inches in your strongest range of motion for a muscle, endurance training. Last one, come on up. That's your stretch. Let's come on back down. Last set. Pulse. 20, 19, 18. Breathe. Whew. Arm positioning is up to you too. Those hands can come to the hips anytime, but not to the thighs for support. Oh, we're more than halfway. This is 13. Ooh. 15. Bigger pulse if you can. 17. Push out to the knees and toes. Last one. Stand. Bring your heels and toes together. Oh my goodness. Good job. Let's come into a walkout now. Standing nice and tall, we'll give those legs a stretch. Breathe in, reach up, and pull forward. Now we're going to walk out into plank. Brace your core here, and in plank, you can lower the knees if you want to. I just want you to lift one leg and put it down, and the other side, and down, up, and down, up, and down, up, and down. One more time on each side. Squeeze the glute. We won't come up for a reason. Last one. Lift the hips. Walk it back. And the knees roll up. Big reach and stretch. And we'll fold forward again. Let's walk it out. Into plank. Knees or toes, elbows or hands. All yours. Brace your core. Now we lift one leg. Put it back down. Lift the other and put it back down. Remember, option knees to floor anytime. Right on, guys. Keep it slow. I know it's tough to slow down. Two more on each side. Suck the belly button in. Last one on each side. Knees down. Sit back. Child's pose. Great job. Now let's come into a table. And we're going to do a little bird dog with a twist. Shoulders down and back. Suck the belly button toward the spine. Hands on your shoulders. Knees on your hips. Reach up with the opposite arm to leg. Good. Now here, I just want you to check your bird dog. So here, we do not drop the head. The shoulders stay down and back. Never let the lower back arch and the belly drop. Suck your tummy in. Now, fingertips and heels to the corners of the mat, and then back to center. Corners and center. Stabilize through the body. Here's three of six and four. Feel that supporting shoulder working hard here too. Last one, you can take a break or hold here. I'm going to inhale and reach. Exhale, knee and elbow together. Speed it up. Reach and pull. Reach and pull. Three and four. Good. Yep, we're going for 10 this time. Good, yep. Remember, your toe can stay on the floor. Your hand can stay on the floor. It's all up to you. Two more. Last one. Knees down, sit back. Excellent job. Okay, now lying on our side, we're going to come into a little adductor. So those are the inside muscles of our thighs. I want you to lay right down and imagine flattening your body up against an imaginary wall. So check that your shin does not come toward the chest, your chin rather does not come toward the chest. Top foot is going to come in front of the bottom leg. Knee points up because we're using it to stabilize, that's all. So just find your support here so you can use it to push like with your hand. And then that bottom leg, check, make sure your neck is relaxed and your head is resting on the arm. We have a tendency to tense up. We don't want headaches later. Ready? Let's pulse through the knee. 1, 2, 3. Good. You got it, guys. Now you can rock around or roll around to find a nice comfortable spot for that bottom hip. Hopefully you'll have a mat or a cushion that you can use. Woo, 5 more. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Rest that leg down. Now we're going to do circles. Lift it up again. Take a break if you need one. And circle with the knee. 1, 2, 3, 4. Going for 10, 6, 7, 9. Last one. Bring up knee flat and release it down. Good. All right. Let's bring it back up and circle. 1, 2, 3. Good. You got it. Almost there. 8, 9. Last one here. And release down. Excellent job. Okay, let's come onto our backs again. Good. Come in for each position. I'm going to do a little bit of hamstrings here. Good. Let's roll up one for a great time. Shoulders down the back. I just want you to tap one heel, bring back, and the other side, and bring back. Tap, and in, and tap, and in. Keep your belly button sucked in toward your spine, and notice how your core works to counterbalance you here. Okay guys, you ready? We're gonna turn this into 4 steps. 4, 3, 2, 1. 4, 3, 2, 1. Good, yep. You can move as fast or as slow as you want to. You can take more than 4 steps or less than 4 steps. But I still want you to suck your belly button toward the spine, whatever variation you're using. Now the difference here between the 4 steps and the single tap is that in between where your hamstrings are working really hard on steps 2 and 3. Good. Breathe deep. Couple more just like that. Squeeze the glutes. Make it work. Last one here. Out and back in. And release. You can bring the knees to the chest. Grab a stretch for the lower back. Great job. Okay, let's roll over. Down dog, toe taps. So again, just remembering that options are optional, so you can bring it down to the knees or the elbows anytime. Table pose, and we're gonna just lift up in the down dog. You can shift around and grab a stretch here if you need to. And then I want you to just tap one toe, bring the hand back, other toe. coming into oblique crunches. Let's just drop those knees to one side. Now, if this is not comfortable for you, you're gonna face in the same direction that your knees are pointing. Otherwise, you're gonna open to the ceiling with your upper body and bring those fingertips to the temples of your right head. Your knees are pointing to the side, so they're right down on the floor here now. We're gonna take a deep breath in. Exhale and squeeze up. Inhale down, super slow. Exhale, crunch. Inhale down. So your options, if you're facing your hip, you're squeezing your shoulders toward that hip, or if you're facing in the same direction as your knees, we're just squeezing those obliques. We're all gonna come there in just a minute. Only twist if it's okay for your back. Inhale down. Exhale up. Now ready, double time. If you want more, let's go. Up and down. Seven more. Six. Five. Keep your shoulders down wide. Three. Two. And last one. Excellent. And now we're all going to come right onto our side. Your bottom hand can support the head if you want. Top fingertips are going to come to the temple behind the head. And I want your elbow pointing toward the sky. Take a deep breath in here. Exhale and squeeze up. Try and touch your elbow to your hip while keeping your fingertips on the side of your head. Feel that here. Right there is where we want it. Ready? Rest. Inhale down. Exhale up. You don't have to keep that bottom hand on the head to support it if you don't need to. Okay? But do give it support if you feel strain or tension in the neck. Three more. Two. Right there at the side body. Last one here. And release, stretch out that arm and leg. And roll over, coming onto your other side. So knees are on the floor, and you can come here right for that oblique pulse first, or you can open that right arm out toward the sky, bring the fingertips to the temples or behind the head. Our knees are pointed to the side on the floor. We take a deep breath into the bottom. Exhale and crunch up, slow. Inhale down. Exhale, crunch up. Inhale down. So remember that option. You can crunch up from the side with no twist instead. Last one, slow. Speed it up if you're ready. For eight. And seven, shoulders down, elbows wide. Five. Four. Good. You got it, guys. Last two. And one. Awesome. And now we'll turn on to our side. And that bottom arm can be down on the floor, or you can support your head with that hand. Top hand comes behind the head, and the elbow points toward the sky. Gaze is straight forward in line with your knees. Inhale, exhale, squeeze up. Elbow comes toward your hip. Hold here just for a second. Feel your obliques work. Check your neck is long. Repetitions now. Down and crunch. Down and crunch. Good. You got it. And four, support the head if you need to. Five. Six, good, yeah. Last one, and release, quick stretch. Excellent, okay. Bear crawl variations. Grab a drink of water, now's a good time. We're gonna come into our next set of movements. We don't have much longer before we start to get into our cool down and our good solid stretch, so let's make this last few minutes count. Coming onto our hands and knees. So, table pose, if you're doing yoga, we can call it bear crawl, if we're doing fitness, and you can curl the toes under, spread those fingers wide. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, lift the knees. Just hold here. Just hold. Check that your knees are directly underneath your hips, and they're 1 to 3 inches up off the floor. Now down and up. Down and up. So just lower the knees, and then lift them up again. Lower and lift. Good. Shoulders down and wide for the entire movement. Four more just like that. Four. Three. Two. And one. Sit back under the heels. Grab a quick stretch. Little teeny break because that's a lot harder than it looks. And we're going to come back for our next variation. So you can come back to that movement if you want to. Or come with me. We're going to do a little combo here. So curl the toes under. Lift the knees up off the floor. We're going to do a little bear squat. Come back to set. Lift one arm, put it down, other arm and then down. Tap one foot back, tap the other foot back. Ready? Yes, not so bad. Bear crawl position. one leg straight back behind you. Suck the belly button in, shoulders down. Lift, tap to the outside of your supporting foot, and then we're going to lift and tap in line with the hip. Let's speed it up. Lift and tap. Lift and tap. That's one. Lift and tap. Lift and two. We're doing six on each side. I want you to move slowly and see how big a range of motion you can get through the hip without moving anything else. Don't move your waist or your shoulders. Just use them to brace. Brace your position. Breathe deeply. Last one, both directions. Excellent. Now lift that heel. Hold it up. Flex the foot back towards you. Don't arch your lower back. And let's pulse. One, two, three, four. Let's try for 15. Seven, eight. Push your elbows down. 11, 12. Almost there, almost there. 14, last one. Knees down. Woo, sit back. Great job. Okay, other side. Back onto those elbows. If this is becoming really uncomfortable for your upper body, you can stand up and bring your hands to the wall anytime. So just a reminder of that modification. Now we're coming to the other side. Straighten that leg out and brace your core. Big arc. Really, really slow to start. Tap to the outside. Big arc and tap in line with the hip. Let's speed it up. Lift and tap. Lift and tap. Don't let that body wobble. And remember, we're moving faster, but we're not moving fast. We're still keeping it slow. Breathe deep. Good. Precision is everything. Now, I call these the lazy workouts just because we're moving slow, but there's nothing lazy about what we're doing. I know we're working really, really hard, so I want you to really focus on those glutes. It's all about precision. Those slow movements are really going to help us with that mind-body connection and precision toning. Two more. Both directions. One more time. Breathe. Great. Now you can rest or hold it here. Lift up that leg. Straighten it out like you want to shoot a laser through your heel. Flex up and back towards you. Suck your belly button in. Notice if your core is slack. And then we're going to pulse. One, two, three, four. Good. Six. Seven, more than halfway. Woo. 11, keep going, guys. 14, last one, knees down. Wow. Sit back, quick stretch. Great job, okay. Now, I feel like we should give those arms a rest. We might come back for a side plank in a little bit, but let's come into a stretch first. Okay, so coming up off the knees, we're just gonna step one foot forward, press those hips toward the floor. Good, you can lengthen back through that back leg if you want to, you can move it a little bit. And then when you're ready, if you can, come up off that back knee, and you can reach the arms straight up toward the sky, pour it out in front in line with the shoulders. I want you to take a look and make sure you can see your front of your toe. Belly button sucks in. Good, straighten out that back leg as much as you're able. Sink down, push into your front heel. Deep breath in. Exhale, hands down to either side of the front foot. Now here, you can come back to low lunge, or you can come with me to intensify, shifting onto the front foot and lifting up into warrior three. So we're finishing off with some balance and some focus. Focus your gaze, your supporting leg is safe. Now for those of you who want even more than this, extra special movement from here, fingertips can come to the floor, toe can come down. We're gonna open that outside hip out to the side. And then bring it back down. Toe can stay down. We're just opening out to the side, shifting, and back down. Two more just like that. Open out. And shift, suck the belly button in. Last one here. Drive on your supporting foot. Good. Excellent. Hands down beside the front foot. And we're going to bring the back knee down. Hands are going to come to the inside now. Good. Yes. Now the hand on the back leg side is nice and solid on the floor. Arm on the front leg side can come to the hip, the knee, or you can reach up toward the sky. So find that extension. If you want more, you can curl the back toe under and lift up off the back knee. You can also wrap that top arm back behind the body and brace it on the opposite hip if that's comfortable for you. Relax your hips toward the floor. Breathe deeply. Great. Now let's inhale, reach up toward the sky, hands down to either side of front foot, and we'll step back and downward dog. Gently press the heels toward the floor one at a time. four, roll around the balls of the feet. And now that left foot can come forward, back knee comes to the floor, low lunge. You can press onto that front knee, tugging your tailbone, sucking the belly button toward the spine, relaxing the hips down toward the floor. Great. If you want more, roll the back toe under, lift that back knee up. You can come into the full warrior one if you want to with me. Sink a little deeper if you're able, press into the back heel. And breathe. Excellent, yep. One more deep breath in. Exhale, hands down to either side of the front foot. You can bring the back knee down for low lunge, or come the knee shift forward and lift up into warrior three. So now again in this pose, stabilizing our supporting leg. If you want more than this, lift that outside hip out to the side and then recenter. Focus your gaze, find your balance. It's a really complex move for that hip and thigh. So I just want you to notice how it feels. Our knee feels okay too. Awesome job. Yes. And then we'll come on back down. Hands on the inside of the front foot. And we'll bring that back knee down to the floor. Good. Find that good stretch. And then you can bring that hand on the front leg side to the knee. Looking up toward the sky. Reaching for that arm. Wide shoulders. Breathe deeply. If you want more, lift the back knee up off the floor. Use your back.
And now let's come on back up.
release that right leg, bring it across, wrapping it behind, and we'll come into our IT band stretch. Standing nice and tall, suck your belly button toward the spine. Hand on the front leg side comes to the hip. Arm on the back leg side reaches up. We brace the core, and then we bend. Arm that stretch through the ribcage. Left hand can stay on the hip, or you can reach across the front of the body if you like, as long as that's okay for your lower back. And now we'll come on up, tip forward, bend the front knee, back leg is straight, and we're lifting our tailbone toward the sky. You can untwist the legs and bring them to hip width apart if that's more comfortable for you. Lift your tailbone toward the sky. Breathe deeply. And now bring both hands to the front and knee. Step the feet out to hip width, and then we roll up shoulders down. Reach up, breathe in. And we stand and then come along to the other side. Standing tall. Shifting to the right leg, bend the right knee. Left shin comes across. We draw that leg into place, or not, and sink right down. Finding that stretch here. Hands can come into prayer, or you can reach up alongside the ears. If you choose to reach up, I want you to feel the muscle engaged in that band around your rib cage, not up in the neck and shoulders, never through the traps. And if you want to just increase that intensity, you can find your gaze on the floor, tip forward, and relax down. Breathe. Relax the arms and neck. And then we'll work our way back up, releasing that left leg behind the right. Standing tall, hand on the front leg side comes to the hip, arm on the back leg side reaches up, we breathe in deep. And then we exhale.